What is Chinese modernization and what is it not?
Let's go find out at this year's annual conference of the Boao Forum for Asia.
The Western path was often thought of as founded during the Industrial Revolution, and that coincided with the era of colonialism. So those who were first modernized were colonizers as well.
What's so special about Chinese modernization?
Well, I think the one thing is the leadership. They have a vision, and then they talk about a roadmap, and then they implement it.
When China speaks of progress and modernization, it is often in the context of a community of shared future and common prosperity, rather than exploitation in the colonial sense.
I have been living in China for the last four decades or so, and what I have noticed is that never any announcement made by the Chinese government had not been implemented. So I think that is the key to success.
When we think of Chinese modernization, what comes to our mind is a very holistic model of development in which China is embracing the challenges of new world in terms of modernization. At the same time, it is preserving peace and order and harmony within its society.
China's now arrived at more or less in key areas at the same technological level as the most advanced countries in the world. The next stage, I think, for Chinese modernization is a very potentially creative phase of offering the world a new kind of modernity.
Chinese modernization has been in some way regulated by a visionary government. There are new things happening here on many fields, and everybody should learn from here.
We cannot just focus on economic development by not aligning and harmonizing the social and political development of society. China has harmonized economic development, political development, and social development. So I think Chinese path of modernization is a model of harmony, which is the essence of this universe.
On top of their exchange of views, we really enjoyed hearing their personal stories with Chinese modernization.
I'm going to bring 12 students from the Philippines after this trip in Boao to see China, to do the same travel that I did when I was a student in 1977 before the reform and opening. And I want to show them, when they see all this modernization of China, each time I will tell them how it was before in 1977. When they ride the maglev train, I will tell them how I went to China in 1977 in a very rickety train with no lavatory. From Hong Kong, we had to stop in a little town called Shenzhen. And now what is Shenzhen? It even has a bigger GDP than many of the modernizing city states.
I used to get frustrated when I walked the streets of Beijing or Shanghai and so on, and those that could afford it were driving around in, you know, American Buicks and Japanese Toyotas and Hondas and Hyundai and so on. And now seeing, wow, I mean, electric vehicles more and more on the streets of the cities, but especially Chinese made. So that gives me great pleasure to see the way in which China's modernization has broadened out across the economy, broadened out across society.
Is Chinese modernization good news for the rest of the world? The answers we heard here have all been clear-cut.
It's made an extraordinary contribution to the global economy. I mean, ever since around about 2007, 2008, China's been the biggest single contributor to global growth. China has contributed more to global growth than any other country. Everywhere, every country, including the United States, would be poorer if China hadn't made this extraordinary contribution.
China's rise could be looked as an opportunity, not as a threat for the rest of the world.
So there should be a greater appreciation that how different countries can find out their own paths to modernization and to success.